assumption that like, if the 25th of December is Christmas, or that a building built in the 1850s is really, really old, sort of reminds me that I'm not from here. It's one of those things that's both important and unimportant, like the color of my eyes or my shoe size. It's one of the details that come together that make up who I am. And details, you know, those sort of snapshot moments that stand out, that's what I write about. More baggage than passenger, I landed, sullen and angry, a refugee child in yet another country. Now, grandmother and artist, gentled by the slow drift of time that smooths the rubble and craters left from collisions of here and home, I'm content with the bargain, with surrendering what I have maybe lost for what I have surely gained by becoming Canadian. Until the first line of our national anthem slaps me with the insinuation that I can never fully belong because it is not and can never be my native land. Walking home, 28 years I've walked this city, marking it mine, the skeins of footsteps stitched into the web of my life, printing its skyline on the map. Sometimes, despite my best efforts, the river and towers of a city I barely remember rise out of legend and spike me with regret for the what if and never was. Alum Gardens. Silent, indrawn breath of time about to speak again. A park bench. A man, goodwill layered, grizzled, stubbled. A bag of wonder bread. A flock of pigeons. At his feet, on the bench, on his shoulders, his lap, his gentle, caressing, calloused hands. What ways has his life led him that alone and old and needy in the cool of dawn, on a feeling, motley of flying city vermin, he feeds the multitude in his soul's hungry place with a plastic bag of plastic bread in an empty park withering into winter. Bloor Street Violet. Feet on concrete, eyes bird high, air and light and wing space above. This fragile pen stroke in space, a gentle touch on the heavy world, is a span of time apart, a place between here and there, cradled in the wind, awash in the silence of life. I wonder, is it this glory that draws desperate souls to release their anchor bodies and buy flight for a split moment at 32 feet? Second per second, and the impact of medium gravity. Broadview at Girard. Waiting for the lights to change, I browse the notice fluttering its phone numbers on the lamppost beside me, idly wondering if it advertises Spanish lessons or maybe a lost cat. So used to scooping information off the page with a casual eye that my world halts for a moment as it hits me that in Chinese I'm illiterate.